My name is Cameron, and I'm part of the Management 106. And for Project 3, I'm talking about global warming and how it will change farming as we know it. Global warming. What is global warming? Well, global warming is an increase in the mean atmospheric temperature. It's caused by greenhouse gases such as CO2. The greenhouse gases go up into the atmosphere and basically act as a blanket, so the heat from the sun comes down to the earth and would usually rebound back out into space, but the greenhouse gases trap it in the atmosphere, therefore creating a warmer environment. Why did I select it? This is a very current issue which will have huge effects on New Zealand, because we're so heavily agricultural based, and with global warming it'll change how plants grow and how animals grow, so for us it is very important. What is causing it? Well, the earth naturally goes through warming and cooling phases, but the amount of greenhouse gases we have emitted into the atmosphere, we're adding to the earth's temperature. Our worst pollutant is fossil fuels. We add what of CO2 into the atmosphere. How this affects production. Global warming will cause a lot more major weather extremes, such as flooding, hurricanes, pretty much any natural disaster apart from an earthquake. So obviously the effects that this will have are broad. So for example, it was lambing time and a huge flood hit, a lot of lambs would get killed, and therefore a lot of our lamb produce will be non-existent, so we won't be able to export to other countries and therefore make a huge loss. Same goes for cropping. A huge flood could wipe out a lot of crops, and which we won't be able to export as well. Higher average temperatures could also affect the growth of animals and plants. Animals don't deal well with high temperatures. Under high temperatures, they become stressed and stop eating, so therefore they will stop growing. Plants, when it gets over 25 degrees, they will wilt and won't grow, and if it stays hot for a long period of time, they will die. And also, some plants, such as the rhubarb, needs low temperatures to stimulate growth. It needs to get below negative 5 degrees in winter to trigger it to go into dormancy. So if the average temperature rises, then the temperature won't get down to negative 5. Well, this affects the consumer, because we will not have as much produce on offer to buy, so things such as meat will be a lot more scarce, and that will raise the price and will mean that only the more wealthy people can purchase these items. How it affects processing / harvest. As said before, the more frequent weather extremes will cause delays and loss of produce. During harvest time, it is very important that you get good weather, and things such as hail or floods will reduce the amount of produce you get. A hailstorm, for example, if you're harvesting fruit, could damage a lot of fruit, and might not be able to sell it to customers, which will get so weather extremes might cause small time frame for harvest. High mean temp could affect the storage and perishability. So if it's on average hotter, the fruit and other vegetables and meat won't store as well, it won't last as well in storage. High stress could also make the taste of meat and horticultural products taste different. high stress lifestyle makes it less tender. Just to recap on what we've talked about, global warming could dramatically affect total production available, the total produce available to consumers. There will be less food security and more countries looking at themselves, looking after just themselves instead of exporting. So countries such as Hong Kong, who can't produce enough for their own country, won't be able to export, won't be able to feed the country. This will lead to things like war and famine, so more people will be starving and there will be more wars in the world because people will be fighting for food. There are solutions. Biofuels and renewable energy are the ways that we need to go to stop the amount of pollution we're putting into the atmosphere. And governments must step up and implement these so that we start